I've spoken to a lot of people, a lot of entertainers, singers, musicians, and people involved in business, etc., in the strange and weird times we have. I'm delighted to welcome a glamorous lass of country music in Ireland who's been going great guns over this past few years, also doing broadcasting indeed herself, and singing and appearing all over the place. Just released a new single within this last few days, and going well also. I'm delighted to say hello to Kerry Fearon. Kerry, how are you?
I'm grand, Jerry. Thanks for having me on. How are you?
A real pleasure, Kerry. A real pleasure. Listen, well done. Well done on all your achievements. You've certainly been noticed in music over this past couple of years.
Thank you. It's been a crazy few years, and it wasn't anything I planned to do as such. It all kind of happened by accident. So, it's just been a crazy journey, and I'm just going with it as long as it goes.
indeed. Well done at all. You know, you've certainly done made a major impression, I'll have to say, in music, and you've recorded a lot of material also.
Yeah, so I'm working on my second album right now, and my first album, it came out just 2 years ago, but I was supposed to be in Texas in April because that album was actually nominated in the top 5 for Pure Country Album in the Academy of Western Artists Awards, which are unfortunately, that's been postponed to August, and I can't see me travelling to Texas in August. But yeah, I've been working on my second album, so obviously the pandemic then has slowed that up as well, and I can't get to record, but hopefully I will soon. But I've released 3 singles off the second album so far, and they've been going good now. I'm very pleased with how they're being received and all that sort of thing.
Indeed, the vast majority of your singles, have had a fantastic reaction. They really have, and you're sort of heavily influenced by American artists.
Yeah, I suppose I would be. Yeah, because I'm into I do a radio program myself, and it's kind of like the music I like that I'm influenced by, which sort of makes sense. But I would listen to a lot of Americana, Ameripolitan, even bluegrass, and folk as well. So I suppose it's just getting a mixture of that, and they'd be my kind of influences, I suppose. Pretty much.
Excellent stuff. Excellent. Well done. Well done on it at all. And you do a program on, I believe it's Dundalk.
Yes, that's right. I was with Downtown Country for 4 years, and I left them last summer and chose to go a bit closer to home. So I was delighted to join the team on Dundalk FM. So I joined it last July or August, and I do a specialist show, which is once a month, and it's called the Boots and Roots Show, and it's every third Saturday of the month. And again, just like the music genres I was mentioning to you there, Jerry, it's bluegrass, folk, a lot of country music, alt country, Americana, honky tonk, western swing, folk music, all that kind of thing. So it's really all roots music, if you like.
Right. Right. Yeah. Well done at all, I have to say. Excellent stuff. And in order to be nominated, for that, it's a great achievement. It really is. I know that the pandemic has put paid to you actually appearing over there, but it definitely is a tremendous achievement to get that.
Oh, yeah, God. Delighted to.
Indeed, so. Indeed, and listen. More recently, you've been through the wars. You've injured yourself.
Oh, sure. Look, like everybody else around here during the lockdown, I was off work for a couple of months, and I've been walking and walking and walking, and I've been walking, up hills and stuff, and I actually started running, and I have a really bad sprain, but I took it. I got it as soon as I went back to work, so I've been walking on it, which I shouldn't have been. But sure, look, I'm hopefully getting it soon tonight.
Right. These things happen. You'll be in flying motion in no time at all.
I hope so. I hope you're right.
Right. Now, you do quite a lot of appearances. I mean, you've appeared at numerous shows all over the place.
Yeah, I do. I have to say, I do a lot of festival slots and gigs in England and Scotland, mainly. I did 3 festivals in Scotland last year, and my last English trip was October. I was on the Lake Blues and Americana Festival in Staffordshire. It was gorgeous. Oh my God, it was so lovely. So yeah, I would do Nottingham and York and places like that. And I was really hoping to get back now this year, but sure, look, hopefully 2021, maybe it will be different. I don't know if I hold out any hope for anything in 2020 right now, to be fair.
Indeed,
it's
yes.
Difficult to know. It's really hard to know.
Indeed. I believe you actually had a trip. I saw something you were doing your tour over here at some stage, I believe. I think it was a little earlier on this year. There was something scheduled, but it didn't happen owing to lockdown.
Yeah, that's right. I was supposed to be in a festival in Nottinghamshire there in June, so it didn't happen. And then the other stuff was there was Texas, didn't happen, and then the rest of the stuff was here. I was supposed to be on the Cathedral Quarter Arts Festival in Belfast. And I was supposed to be, at Westport Folk and Bluegrass Festival as well, things like that. So it's all gone, but sure, look, everybody's in the same boat, and hopefully things will get better.
Indeed. That's for sure. Everybody is in the same boat. It must be sort of a major shock to your sister. I always say this, that one thing that nearly every singer has said they miss is actually meeting the people.
Yeah, I absolutely miss meeting the people. You know, like, to me, it's not just singing the songs or whatever. It is the traveling and, getting to see new places and then meeting old friends and new. That was all part of it. Like, and I do miss that so much, so that's why I've been constantly saying on my Facebook posts and all, stay safe, everybody, because I want to see you on the other side of this, So it is. It's definitely hard. Like,
indeed, yes, indeed. Well, that is the thing that, it's tough going at the moment, but we will get through it.
Yes, thank God.
Yes, in time. But are you able to do, have you been doing any Facebook Lives or anything like that?
No, I haven't, Jerry, because I work, so I feel like it's for, the individual singer-songwriters who this is their livelihood. And they're struggling as it is. And to me, I think, they're using it to try and get tips or whatever. That's what they're living on. And it's not fair for the likes of me to clog up the news feed, if you like. So I've actually helped other, artists to get set up and do live streams. And as well as that, instead of doing that, I focused on my radio show. And my radio show would be full of independent artists. So I focused on helping them and just put more of a focus basically on the radio show. And it has been like a social event for me every month because there's a lot of social interaction on my Facebook whenever the show goes out. And, there'll be people listening in Norway and Germany and England and Texas even. I'm sure the crack does be 90. So that's okay by me. I'll let, the artists who need to do that, that's okay. But I am working and thank God.
Yes. Yes, well, I'll have to say, well done. A very, a very unselfish approach to it. I'll have to say, because there are many artists that, as you see, are not working at all, and their sole income is from singing and performing live.
Yeah, that's right. Whereas to me, music isn't my job. It's what I love to do. But I'm a teacher and I'm also a support worker. It was Irish Autism Action I was working for, but they've gone into liquidation, but I'm still doing the job, if you like. So that's what I do, to make a living. Music isn't my living, and I shouldn't be clogging up the news feed. It is saturated with live streams, and I'd rather see the individual singer-songwriter who needs it, to be getting the attention basically from the live stream.
Well done. I must say that really, 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 really is a totally unselfish approach to the whole thing. Well done on, actually yourself on the radio program and giving the independent artists, a good, some decent exposure and airplay that they otherwise may not get.
Oh, thank you. Same to yourself, Jerry. It takes it all,
Indeed,
because it's hard to get radio play on the bigger on the commercial stations. It is, and so at least we do look after the independent artists. I have to say, I know that coming from an artist point of view as well as a presenter point of view. So.
Indeed, so yeah. Well, I think it's crucial, for to play everybody and talk to everybody indeed in music that you're not just picking on the usual suspects, the usual say half dozen people, you know, and that's not taking away from their talent or their success in any way. It's just that
some need it more than others.
There's a lot of people out there. There's a lot of what I'm finding is that there's a huge amount. And this is the thing that astounds me about Ireland, is the incredible amount of talent which comes out. And many of the, you know, of those artists never make it to the top. But they're still incredibly talented.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Yeah, you'll see that right across the board. It's very, very hard. But, that's why I would try and help those artists rather than the ones who don't need. You know?
Yes, indeed. Kerry, listen, it's been lovely to catch up with you. I wish you all the success in the world.
Thank you very much.
Good luck with the new album. And listen, it's really been great talking to you. And well done on it all. You've achieved a lot.
Oh, thank you so much. Thank you.
Kerry, listen, you take care, and as I always say, you know, stay safe and stay well, and fingers crossed, we'll meet up on the other side.
Thanks, God, Jerry. Thank you so much for having me on. Thank you.